Hello, I'm Mr. R. Mitchell, a retired lecturer in mythology, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm giving throwing some light, the way my father used to think and speak to the people, preach gospel, and from the very basic fundamental principles. And here he is giving a differentiation between soul and body, and what is how you should differentiate and how you should deal with them. So he said that the physical body is the concrete self, or the that you can see, whereas the spiritual self is the abstract self which you cannot see, but is known by quality. So secular self is quantity, or flesh as it is in Adam, whereas the spiritual self is our quality, that the way we act, way we perform our deeds. So a tree is known by the fruit it bears. So it's the spiritual self that make you to bear the fruit. And secular self is the one that performs the duties which the soul tells the body to do. So your soul is the driver of your destiny. And your body is the vehicle. So the driver has four spiritual states that goes with the from the birth when he is once born, then he becomes twice born, and then he looks to become one with God. This I have explained in other videos. So this is the in this dark age, people don't speak the truth. There's no spiritual light left. With the result, the whole religion hangs on the thread of your conscience. If you have a good conscience, then you won't do bad things. So if you have good conscience, clear conscience, then you are a religious person. If your conscience is dirty, you want to cheat other people, then you are not a religious person, but you are a son of a Satan, which are bastards worse than those born of the prostitutes. So in Jesus, the saints do not count. It is the righteousness that counts. So we are no more slave to the saints, but to the righteousness. So anybody who talks about sins in churches, he has nothing to do with Christ Jesus. That man is a blind guide of the blind and antichrist. And that's why they call our brother, anointed brother Christ Jesus, as Lord and God and everything, just to please the once upon stones which over which they make the living. Stones are simple-minded people devoted to Christ Jesus. But these dog-collar people put on dog-collar, they tell them, oh, they are working for God, but they draw money from the purse which the other people pay. They are Judas Iscariot of the worst form. So in this dark age, such clever people, they take advantage, and then they teach or preach in the churches that is pleasing to their congregation, once-born congregation. Once-born congregation, they have no knowledge of the difference between soul and body. They are told that you are Jew of the physical body and they accept it. They are told you are a Muslim of physical body that was born and died. They accept it. So I'm Sikh, Hindu, so and so. They are not born, they never die. Because this soul comes from our father, is eternal, is not the one which perishes. His physical body that perishes, and soul takes another clothing in the next reincarnation. So this is the age which we call Kal Yug. Kal mean famine, Yug mean age. Age of famine of religious light, darkness. That is why Christ Jesus come himself to give us the light through his word. But if the people who put on the dog collars in churches and other, they have no idea of what Christ Jesus stands for. If you ask them what is light and what is darkness, I can bet you, you know, they hardly any one of them knows what is light. They will say Christ Jesus is the light, but ask them what is light, they have no idea. So let's carry on what my father was preaching. It is the fourth age, Kal Yug, in which the clever and selfish people, that's the nature of the people in churches, who make fool of the stones and live on them, people are propagating falsehood. Falsehoods are abstract lies which ordinary man cannot detect. You detect it through these logical reasoning. Through press and platform. Platform means that in churches, you know, they have put uniform and everybody listen to them. Especially in democratic rules, to secure votes. You know, in before that we used to have a rule which based upon tribes, tribal chief. Still are in Africa, Brazil, they have tribal chief, and they are more responsible because you can't change the tribe. So they are chiefs are very responsible people. Whereas in democracy, you change the party from Labour to Conservative, Conservative to Communist and this and that. So these are non-identifiable names. So they are not the real selves which should take part in secular politics. So in democratic rules, when these false political parties take their heads out, then to secure vote, the leaders have to be psychic. Otherwise, they can't secure the votes. Only wise have respect for truth. Wise men, you know, in the society, they have respect for the truth. They would speak the truth, while those other people, clever people, they would always seek votes. In democratic rule, wise men cannot be elected because the voters are mostly simpletons or selfish people. So preachers should wake up. Always talk in terms of identification. One's wife, children, property is of his body and not of his soul. Do you understand? If I and the children go to a church or go to any religious place, then our physical body relationship finishes. Over there is the spiritual self. So we are here in the house, they could be my children, but in the church or Gurdwara, they are my brethren. So communal selves, being of the soul, have no wife or children. So there we have brethren, we have one father, God. The marriage is of the body and not of any communal self. Sometimes people speak of marriage between Christian and a Muslim, or a Hindu and a Sikh. That is all nonsense, because they are the spiritual self, which spiritual self has no gender, you know, male or female, as in flesh we are. There is a male and female in spiritual analogy, but marriage is taking place between physical selves, boy and a girl, and not between Hindu or a Sikh or a Muslim, because they are brethren. They cannot be married, spiritual self. So keep away from these falsehoods. Their result is disastrous, because they bring in the sectarian riots, as in Ireland, in India. Many people died during these sectarian riots. In Nigeria, for example, Nigeria should be not experiencing such a problem, because they have the tribal marks over their cheeks, and the people over there should give recognition to the tribe. Mostly we lived in Ghana 14 years. Over there the people honor their tribal chief. If a chief say anything, they all then do obey him, you know. They don't just flout. But today, these days, you know, these educated people, they say, oh, he's just a chief. And now the governments have taken over. So chiefs are just figurehead. And that's why you have sectarian riots in that part of the world. Sectarian riots are also taking their ugly head out in Russia, where the communists had put these dog-collared people, these priests, you see them, which have no place in Christ Jesus, lowering these simpleton in Russia, making their following, creating an army of sectarian riots. So such sectarian riots will propagate. So that's what I told one man who came from Russia many years ago. He was very proudly telling the British congregation in a church, they won't allow us to read the Bible. And I used to have a plastic Bible. When the police came, I would put them in the water kettle and hide it. And they will come and search my room, and they go. After he had finished the lecture, I asked him, here we have the freedom of speech. You can read Bible as you like it. Tell me, do they have a sectarian riots as they are in Ireland, Catholic and Protestant fighting with each other? He said, no, there isn't any. So I asked him, then which country is better, Russia or this country? Then he was surprised, you know. Then he said, Russia, you know. But he made the fool of the congregation by giving them pathetic story. Oh, they were very happy to listen to him. So nobody wants to listen to gospel truth. But falsehood, you know, they are prepared to listen. When I talk to that church people, nobody wants to know me. But that man from Russia, who was giving them fascinating falsehood stories. So our Father, God bless you, and hope you will understand a bit better.